Yasodhanandana Brajajanaranjana Yamuna Tiravanachari Yamuna Tiravanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari
Jaya Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivraja Kachara Shtodraksa Srimad is Divine Guru Shilabhai Charanarvinda Bhakti Vedanta Goswami Maharaj Shilabhupada Ki Iskon Devat Santhapaka Chara Shilabhupada Ki Jaya Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivraja Kachara Shtodraksa Srimad is Divine Grace Shilabhakta Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada Ki Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Nama Chara Shilahardas Thakur Ki Prem se kaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrindaki Sri Sri Radha Krishna Gop Gopinath Shyamakunda Radha Kunda Sri Giri Govardhan ki Brajabhumi Sri Vrindavan Dham ki Purushottam Kshetra Sri Jagannath Puri Dham ki Navadvip Mayapur Dham ki Gangamai Jamuna Mai ki Bhakti Devi Tulasi Maharani ki Kaliyuga Pavan Sri Harinama Sankirtan ki Hare Krishna Mahamantra ki Srila Prabhupada Transcendental Book Distribution ki Nitai Gaur Premanande All glories to assemble devotees All glories to assemble devotees All glories to assemble devotees All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Agyanati Mirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yadatasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharani Nirvisheshi Shunyavadi Paschat Deshatarani Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 11 Chapter 17 Chapter entitled Description of the Varnashram System, Text 28. Sayam Pratar Upaniya Bhaiksham Tasmai Nivedayet Yat Cha Anyat Api Anugyatam Upayunjita Samyata Sayam Pratarupaniya bhaiksham tasmai nivedayet yachanyat api anugyatam upayunjita samyata sayam pratar upaniya bhaiksham tasmai nivedayet yachanyat api anugyatam upayunjita samyata sayam pratar upaniya bhaiksham tasmai nivedayet yachanyat api anugyatam upayunjita samyata. Sayam in the evening, Prata in the morning, Upaniya bringing bhaikshyam, food that is collected by begging, tasmai unto him, the acharya, nivedayet, one should deliver, yat, that which, cha, also, anyat, other things, api, indeed, anugyatam, that which is permitted, upayunjita, one should accept, samyata, being fully controlled. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Translation: in the morning and evening, one should collect foodstuffs and other articles and deliver them to the spiritual master. Then, being self-controlled, one should accept for oneself that which is allotted by the Acharya. Purport: one who desires to receive the mercy of a bona fide spiritual master should not be eager to accumulate the paraphernalia of sense gratification. Rather, whatever one is able to collect, one should offer at the lotus feet of the Acharya. Being self-controlled, one should humbly accept that which is allotted by the bona fide spiritual master. Every living entity must ultimately be trained to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But until one has become expert in the techniques of spiritual service, one should offer everything to the spiritual master, who is completely realized in the process of worshipping the Lord. The spiritual master sees that the disciple is advanced in Krishna consciousness. He then engages the disciple in directly worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead. A bona fide spiritual master does not use anything for his personal sense gratification and entrusts to his disciple only as much material opulence as the disciple can properly offer to the lotus feet of the Lord. The example may be given that when an ordinary father tries to train his son in business and other material activities, he entrusts to the son only as much wealth as the son can intelligently engage in profitable enterprises without foolishly wasting the father's hard-earned money. Similarly, the bona fide spiritual master teaches his disciple to worship the Lord, and an immature disciple must simply deliver everything to the lotus feet of the Guru, just as an immature child does not keep a personal bank account, but rather receives his maintenance from the father, who trains the son to be responsible. If one cheats oneself by defying the order of a bona fide spiritual master or Krishna, one certainly becomes a non-devotee or sense enjoyer and falls from the spiritual path. Therefore, one should be trained to serve a bona fide spiritual master and thus become mature in Krishna consciousness. Sayam pratar upaniya bhaiksham tasmai nivedayat yachanyat api anugyatam upayinjita samyata. So this 17th chapter is describing about the Varnashram system, and the whole principle of Varnashram is submission and sense control. To be trained in sense control so that ultimately one can be submissive, and when one is submissive, then it is possible for him to perfect his service attitude. So the entire Varnashram is designed to inspire the feeling and mood of service. Ore mudha lokashuna chaitanya mangal chaitanya mahima yate janibe sakal krishna lila bhagavate kohe vedavyas chaitanya lila ravyasa vrindavana das. So Prabhupada mentions in this purport the importance of being a servant to the spiritual master. And many times one may feel that spiritual master means only someone from whom one is initiated. But there are the Shiksha Gurus, the Diksha Gurus, Path Pradarshak Guru, various kinds of spiritual teachers and masters. So the whole idea is how we can replace our whimsical ideas about what is good for me with the instructions and the desires of the Vaishnavas. So we have the example of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, who is at the age of 90 plus. One may think that one needs to follow the spiritual master or teachers or follow an authority till a certain stage or an age, and maybe after some time one outgrows that principle and he becomes like the teacher for everybody. But spiritual life is not like that. So Kaviraj Goswami is in his 90s, and that is the time when he wrote the Chaitanya Caritamrita. So he's clarifying very beautifully that this Chaitanya Charitamrita which I'm trying to write is not in competition with the other literature, Chaitanya Bhagavat, written by Vrindavan Das Thakur. So he says, first of all, I accept Vrindavan Das Thakur to be like the Vyasadev, just like Vyas, what Vyasadev is for Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Lilate Vyasa Vrindavana Das. For Mahaprabhu's Lila, the Vyas is Vrindavan Das Thakur. And so he says, Vrindavana Dasa Koila Chaitanya Mangal Yahara Shravana Nashe Sarva Amangal. And this literature, Chaitanya Bhagavat, is also so powerful that simply by hearing, all inauspiciousness is destroyed. And when you hear this Chaitanya Bhagavat, one understands the glories of Chaitanya and Nityananda Prabhu. Chaitanya nitayare yate janiye mahima yate jani krishna bhakti siddhante rasima. And along with that, one also understands the summit and the limit of Krishna bhakti. Just by hearing, studying, reading this Chaitanya Bhagavat, the best of the philosophy is embedded within the pages of the Chaitanya Bhagavat. So therefore, Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Prema Tattva Sar, Bhava Tattva, Rasa Tattva, Lila Tattva are. When we speak about Krishna Bhakti Siddhanta, it comprises of these six things. Six tattvas together comprise Krishna Bhakti Siddhanta. Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Prema Tattva, Bhava Tattva, the various emotions, Rasa Tattva, the mellows, and Lila Tattva, the various pastimes. All of this and more is there in the pages of Chaitanya Bhagavat. ભાગવત યત ભક્તિ સિદ્ધાંતે રસાર લિખ્યા છે ઇહા જાની કોરિયા ઉદ્ધાર દેટ વોટ એવર ફિલોસોફી ઇઝ દેર ઇન ધ શ્રીમદ ભાગવતમ દ એસેન્સ ઓફ દેટ ઇઝ દેર ઇન ચૈતન્ય ભાગવત સો ફિલોસોફિકલી ધીસ ચૈતન્ય ભાગવત ઇઝ કમ્પ્લીટ ઇટ ઇઝ પરફેક્ટ એન્ડ કમ્પ્લીટ એન્ડ નોટ ઓનલી દેટ ચૈતન્ય મંગલ શુને યદી પાષંડી યવન સેહ મહા વૈષ્ણવ હોય તત્ક્ષણ હુએવર હિયર્સ ધીસ ચૈતન્ય ભાગવત ઇન્સ્ટન્ટલી બિકમ્સ અ ગ્રેટ વૈષ્ણવ ઇવન ઇફ હી ઇઝ કમિંગ ફ્રોમ અ બેકગ્રાઉન્ડ ઓફ કમ્પ્લીટ સેન્સ ગ્રેટિફિકેશન પાષંડી યવન ઇવન ઇફ હી ઇઝ બ્રેકિંગ ઓલ ધ રેગ્યુલેટરી પ્રિન્સિપલ્સ સિમ્પલી બાય હિયરિંગ ધ ચૈતન્ય ભાગવત one becomes purified, one becomes transformed. And so he says, Manushya rachite nare aiche granta dhanya Vrindavan dasa mukhe vakta sri chaitanya. And this Chaitanya Bhagavat has actually been authored by Lord Chaitanya himself. Manushya rachite nare. One should not think some human being has written this Chaitanya Bhagavat. This has been actually written by Lord Chaitanya himself. Vrindavan Das Mukhe, only Vrindavan Das Thakur became an instrument. So therefore, from every perspective, this Chaitanya Bhagavat is perfect and complete. It is the essence of Mahaprabhu's Leelas, and Mahaprabhu's Leelas became manifest to the whole world through Vrindavan Das Thakur. And therefore the world can get transformed just with this Chaitanya Bhagavat. When Prabhupada was in America, the initial years, Hayagriv Prabhu, he was an author and an English professor. So he saw that Prabhupada is, you know, handwriting all of these books with his own hand. So he offered to Prabhupada that maybe I should type some of these manuscripts. So Prabhupada gave him a bunch of manuscripts. So he typed them and brought them next day. And he said, Prabhupada, I've completed this. Are there any more? So Prabhupada took him inside the room. And there was a big trunk. And Prabhupada opened that trunk. That trunk was filled with manuscripts. So Hayagriv Prabhu looked at Prabhupada and said, Swamiji, this is a lifetime of typing. Prabhupada said, no, several lifetimes. And Prabhupada said, right now I am only giving Gita, Bhagavatam. But then beyond that, we have Ramayana, Mahabharata, Vedanta Sutra, Upanishads, Puranas. So Prabhupada could have potentially given unlimited literature. So there is no end to Krishna Katha. And therefore here, the first principle which Srila Prabhupada established, the books must be distributed, the books must be published and distributed so that everyone is on the same page with respect to the Siddhanta. What is the exact philosophy of Krishna consciousness? And so, this Srimad Bhagavatam and the Chaitanya Bhagavat, the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the Bhagavad Gita, all of this represent that philosophy, that Bhakti Siddhanta. Swairachharabdi sammagnan jivan gaurangri pangaje Udhritya Sharanapatta Mahatmyam Samabodhayat Yastasya Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhur Guru Atyudara Padam Bhoja Dhulisyam Janma Janmani. The Jiva is experiencing the greatest distress due to his independent whimsical lifestyle. Swair Achar Abdhi. So the Jiva is drowning in the ocean of whimsical desires. Swair achar abdhi sammagnan. That is the real problem for the conditioned soul. Therefore, how he can transform that desire and align those desires just like iron filings are arrayed randomly. But when a magnetic field comes, under the influence of that magnetic field, all the iron filings move in similar direction. There is harmony amongst them. Like that, desires for sense gratification are like randomly arrayed iron filings. The jiva himself does not know what is good for me. Therefore, when those desires come under the influence of a divine personality, the desires of the devotees, the Vaishnava Sangha, the Vaishnava Icha, that magnetic field puts all our desires in tune with Krishna's pleasure. That is the beginning of auspiciousness for the conditioned soul. And therefore, in order to understand the difference between my independent whimsical desires, which will ultimately be for my destruction, what is the difference between those desires and Krishna's desires and the Vaishnava's desires, which will create auspiciousness for me? The Shastras exist. Therefore, the Shastra exists to create that transformation. One of the book distributors was selling books in Spain. So there was one gentleman who had shifted from, you know, Jamnagar, which is on the outskirts of Dwarka, next to Dwarka. And he was from Gujarat, so he went to Spain to do business. So he passed by the book table and he was curious and he stood there and he saw this book, and it was Krishna books. So Krishna book he saw. And this devotee was enthusiastically preaching, saying, "This is Krishna book, 10th canto, Krishna's pastimes, please purchase it." So this person, he picked it up, looked at it and said, "I am from near Dwarka. I am from Krishna's hometown. What you are going to teach me about Krishna? I know everything." So, you know, this businessman had gone to Spain, and many people had been telling him that to do business in Spain, you need to learn Spanish. Right? So he did not know Spanish. He thought that Jai Shri Radha Randanishwar Bhagavan ki. He had so much confidence in his business skills. He thought that I know Gujarati, that is enough. What is the need for learning Spanish and everything? So this devotee who was distributing the books, when he heard that I know everything about Krishna, he said, "Oh, you know everything about Krishna, but you don't know Spanish. So why don't you purchase two books, one in English, one in Spanish, and use these books to learn Spanish?" So Krishna inspires book distributors to speak the right word at the right time. So immediately he said, "Oh, that's a good idea. That's not a bad idea. I don't know Spanish. This is a good opportunity." So he purchased both the Krishna books. And he actually learned Spanish and he became a devotee, and now he's in charge of one of the centers in Malaga. So Krishna has his ways of attracting, you know, souls through the books. So the books basically establish the essence of the philosophy. And so here he says that ata eva bhajaloke chaitanya nityananda khandive samsara sukha pabe premananda. That just by worshipping Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda Prabhu, khandive samsara dukha pabe premananda, the dukkha, the distress of the material existence will be destroyed and I will experience prema. And so, every conditioned soul is experiencing this lamentation. And so Bhagavatam describes Yasyam vai shruyamanayam krishne paramapurushe bhaktir utpadide pumsa shoka moha bhayapa. So the biggest challenge for the conditioned soul is, because he is trying to enjoy sense gratification independent of Krishna, all of his efforts ultimately lead to lamentation. And therefore, by coming in contact with Krishna Katha, the first thing which happens is the jiva feels, why should I lament? Because I have the greatest asset, the lotus feet of Krishna. I have the greatest wealth, Krishna Katha, Krishna Nama. And therefore there is nothing else to be achieved because I have attained the highest. And therefore contact with Krishna Katha helps the conditioned soul overcome his lamentation. Otherwise, any amount of adjustments of circumstances within this material world, the jiva will continue to suffer. When I joined the ashram in Chopati, we had one brahmachari who joined with me. And I was in the kitchen at that time, so this brahmachari was also sent to serve with me in the kitchen. So after 1 week, he came up to me and started complaining that I am such a famous speaker in my village on Hindu dharma. When I stand up and speak, the whole village comes. I came to ISKCON so that I can preach Sanatan dharma. You guys have put me in the kitchen to make chapati? You think I have come to ISKCON to make chapati? I have come to ISKCON to preach dharma. So I said, Baba, why you are complaining to me? I am also in kitchen only. So two of us having conversation is not going to help. So you find out whoever has sent you and discuss with them. So after one more week, again, he came up and said, hey, what is this? I came to preach Sanatan Dharma, I am in kitchen making chapati, I didn't come to make chapati. So then finally after, 15-20 days, he left the temple. That was his maximum, what he could handle. So after 10 years, I met him in a program. He came up to me running and said, Prabhu, you know what? After marriage, my wife got back pain every day. I am making chapati at home. Maybe I should have tried a little more, a few more days. That would have been better. So we may try to adjust, but to whatever extent is possible, we cannot always control the circumstances. So therefore Bhagavatam says, Yat Srinvato Apaiti Aratir Vitrishna Sattvam Chashuddhyati Achirena Pumsa Bhaktim Harotat Purushit Sattvam Tadeva Haram Vadamanya Sechit. When one comes together and hears Srimad Bhagavatam every day, there are five effects. First, Aratir, distaste for Harikatha goes away. Vitrishna. Second, material hankering dissipates. Sattvam cha shuddhyati, sattvagun, mode of goodness, increases. Fourth, devotional service arises. Fifth, purushe cha sakhyam. When all of these manifest, then one develops feeling, attachment, affection for other devotees. Tadeva haram vadamanya sechet. So Parikshit is saying, may I always carry this garland of Harikatha around my neck. So the question arises that as far as Chaitanya Bhagavat is concerned, it is the perfect grantha which has glorified Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Bhakti Siddhanta Tattva of Srimad Bhagavatam is there. It can purify instantly. It has been written directly by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Kaviraj Goswami is glorifying Chaitanya Bhagavat in every possible way. Then the question arises, then why you have to write Chaitanya Caritamrita? Who told you to write? What is your intention? If someone has already performed seva meritoriously and it is perfect seva, if you are trying to do the same thing, are you trying to supersede? Are you trying to compete? Are you trying to display your superiority? What is your intention? So Kaviraj Goswami is clarifying the intention behind his service. Because bhakti is determined by intention and not by action. Action follows the intention. Anukulena Krishna Anushilanam Bhaktir Uttama. If the intention is anukulena Krishna, pleasurable for Krishna, then that becomes bhakti. Otherwise, we can see that Yashoda Mai made Krishna cry. But that was most pleasing to Krishna. Why? Because her intention was to please Krishna, was to protect Krishna. So therefore, the intention needs to be clarified here. So Vrindavan Das Thakur's Chaitanya Bhagavat is already there. So Kaviraj Goswami says, the real reason why I am writing this Chaitanya Charitamrita is Chaitanya Chandrar Lila Ananta Apar Varnite Varnite Granta Hoila Vistar. That as Vrindavan Das Thakur wrote about Mahaprabhu's pastimes in Chaitanya Bhagavat, he became so absorbed that the entire Chaitanya Bhagavat, by the time Mahaprabhu took sannyas, the pastimes became voluminous. The whole Chaitanya Bhagavat became filled with so many pastimes of Mahaprabhu's before sannyas. And at a certain point, he had to publish the book also. You can't go on writing forever. So therefore, Nityananda Lila Varnane Hoila Avesh Chaitanya Chandrarila Rahila Avashesh. And specifically, Vrindavan Das Thakur became absorbed with ecstasy describing Nityananda Prabhu's pastimes. So many of Mahaprabhu's pastimes, especially after sannyas, could not be covered in Chaitanya Bhagavat. So therefore, at that point, Seisaba Lilara Shunite Vivaran Vrindavana Vasi Bhaktir Utkantitaman. The devotees in Sri Vrindavan Dham, all of them approached me and they wanted to hear Mahaprabhu's pastimes, especially after sannyas. So those pastimes were not covered in Chaitanya Bhagavat of Vrindavan Das Thakur. And therefore, in Vrindavan Dham, Kaviraj Goswami was sitting on the bank of Radha Kund and hearing from the lotus lips of Raghunath Das Goswami. Because when Raghunath Das Goswami came from Jagannath Puri to Sri Vrindavan Dham, at that point, after Mahaprabhu's disappearance, he had decided to jump from the top of Govardhan and commit suicide. And at that time, Rup and Sanatan met him and somehow convinced him to speak about Mahaprabhu's pastime so that he can overcome his feelings of separation. Shunyayate Mahagoshtam Girindro Ajagarayate Vyagra Tundayate Kundam Jivatu Rahitasyame. That Raghunath Das Goswami first experienced viraha from Mahaprabhu. Then he experienced viraha, separation from Rupa and Sanatan, because he outlived them. But in separation from these great souls, he explains that Shunyayate Mahagoshtam, this 12 forests of Vrindavan, although filled with unlimited spiritual potency and power, appear to be a dreary void. Shunyayate. Girindra Jagarayate, in the absence of such Vaishnava devotees, this Govardhan Giriraj appears to be a huge python. Vyagra Tundayate Kundam, in the absence of Rupa and Sanatan, the Radha Kund, the most auspicious, worshipable, holy place, appears to be the open, gaping mouth of a ferocious tiger. Jivatu Rahitasyame. And therefore, the essence of Vrindavan Dham is service, association, and the blessings of the Vaishnavas. If the Vaishnavas are not there and the Vaishnavas cannot be served and pleased, one cannot experience Sri Vrindavan. And therefore, Raghunath Das Goswami, he was sitting on the bank of Radhakund describing glories of Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Lila Ratnasar Swaruper Bhandar Tehothuila Raghunate Rakunte Taha Kichu Yeshinilu Taha Iha Vistarilu Bhaktagana Dilu Ei Bhete. Whatever was seen by Swarup Damodar Goswami of Mahaprabhu's pastime was written by him in his diary. Swaruper Bhandar Tehothuila Raghunate Rakunte. And from Swarup Damodar Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami understood those pastimes, because Raghunath Das Goswami was known as Swaruper Raghunath. Mahaprabhu put him under the care of Swarup Damodar Goswami. So he was the most authorized representative who understood, heard and could speak Mahaprabhu's pastimes. Taha kichuye shunilu taha iha vistarilu, that he spoke on the bank of Radhakund. The Vaishnav Samaj in Vrindavan heard them, and Kaviraj Goswami was part of that. And therefore, he wanted to share this with other Vaishnavas. Ei antalila sar sutra madhye vistar kari kichu karilu varnan iha madhye mariyabe varnitena parijabe ei lila bhaktagana dhan. So Kaviraj Goswami wanted to write even the antalila pastimes in madhyalila itself in brief, because he felt iha madhye mariyabe, while writing madhyalila, if I am 95 years old, I die. Varnitena paritabe, if antalila pastimes are not revealed, at least this synopsis which I am giving in the madhyalila, eilila bhaktagana dhan, it will become the wealth for the devotees. Sankshepe ei sutra kaila je iha nalika age taha koriba vistar. So he says, I am writing this right now. Sankshepe ei sutra kaila, whatever I am not able to write here, je iha na likhila aage taha kariba vistar, I will write in future. When will I write? Jadi Mahaprabhur, if Mahaprabhu has a desire and then I survive for future, jadi tatatina jiye Mahaprabhur kripa hoye ichha bhari kariba vistar. If Mahaprabhu gives his blessings and my lifespan expands, then I will describe Mahaprabhu's antalila pastimes to my heart's content. But what is more important at this point is not to just glorify in detail as per my desire, but I must present Mahaprabhu's entirety of pastimes for the Vaishnava's pleasure. So therefore, although it was strange and odd that in the middle of a text, the synopsis of the next section is described. So in one sense, there is no symmetry. But he was not concerned with being literary, being attractive from literary point of view, but he was more concerned with the fact that Mahaprabhu's pastimes must be shared. So therefore, the main reason he was doing that was for the pleasure of the Vaishnava Sangha. And so he says that because Vrindavan devotees wanted me to write this, therefore I take the Vrindavan devotees' order on my head. And therefore I am writing this Chaitanya Charitamrita. So the Vaishnavas in Vrindavan desired that. That was the first reason. Now he describes the second reason why he wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Again, he is explaining his intention more clearly. Vrindavana kalpadrume suvarna sadan maha yoga peetataha ratna simhasan. In Vrindavan there is a place where on a beautiful altar tatevasi ache sada Brajendra Nandan Sri Govinda Deva nama sakshatamadan. Sri Govinda Dev are installed in the beautiful temple of Govinda. And in that Govinda Dev temple, Sahasra Sevaka Seva Kore Anukshan Sahasra Badane Na Hoye Varnan. At that moment, this is Govindev temple was inaugurated in 1590 by Srila Jiva Goswami. And Chaitanya Caritamrita got published in 1616 May. So in that period was when Chaitanya Caritamrita was written in Govindadev temple. So at that moment, the Sri Govinda temple in Vrindavan is being described by Kaviraj Goswami when he was present. Sahasra sevaka seva kore anukshan, sahasra vadane seva na yaya varnan. Hundreds and thousands of sevaks were there in Govindadev temple. The Govinda temple was the hub of complete spiritual activity. If you go today, you will find it very desolate, deserted. You cannot even imagine. So therefore, the principle of Krishna Seva continues. The details of how the Seva is very active at some place, and then due to the influence of time factor, there is some kind of difficulty and challenge that can never be predicted. So therefore, just because things are going well at some point doesn't mean it will always go on like that. The influence of time factor does not leave even the temples which were installed by the Goswamis, who were manjaris from the spiritual world. The temples which were installed under their instruction and guidance, they can go through ups and downs by the influence of history and time. And therefore, Sevara Adhyaksha Sri Pandita Haridas Tarayasha Guna Sarve Jagate Prakash. Amongst all the sevaks, the main sevak, his name was Pandit Haridas. And this Pandit Haridas qualities are described here. Sushila Shahishnu Shanta Vadanya Gambhir Madhura Vachana Madhura Cheshta Mahadhir Sabara Samman Karta Koren Sabar Hit Kautilya Matsari Himsa Na Janitarachit. He was filled with divine qualities like tolerance, sweet speech, sweet dealings, giving respect to others, not finding fault, free from tendency for envy and violence. He was just filled with all divine qualities. And therefore, he just had all the qualities which are present in Krishna. Krishnaraya sadharana sadguna panchas se sabha gunera tare sharire nivas. All those good qualities were there. But amongst all those qualities, the most prominent quality was Vaishnavera gunagrahi na dekhay dosh kayamane vakya kare Vaishnava santosh. He was free from the tendency to find fault. He understood that Vaishnavas may come in various flavors, various varieties, but I need the Vaishnavas' mercy and kripa to actually reach Krishna. I cannot do that on my own. So therefore, when we look at the Vaishnavas, there are two ways of looking at them. One way is to think, I have something they don't have. I have something they don't have. I have something that person does not have. Therefore, I am superior. The second way is looking is that, okay, there may be differences amongst the Vaishnavas in different ways, but is there one thing which all of us have in common? What is it that we have in common? We are under the influence of Maya. Yes or no? How many are under the influence of Maya? So that is something in common. And because we have that in common, therefore, we all need the support of each other to actually take shelter of Krishna. And therefore, when an individual person comes and makes a petition, the government may or may not take it seriously. But when a group comes and makes a petition, then even the biggest, most powerful government has to take it seriously. And therefore, Sankirtan basically means when we all come together and make a common petition. And what is that? We are all suffering. We are all under the influence of Maya. Please protect us. Please save us. So that mood where we accept the common factor amongst all of us that yes, I need the other devotee's mercy. So Vaishnavera gunagrahi na dekhe dosh. Not seeing the fault, accepting the good quality. Kaye mane vakye kore Vaishnava santosh. When I see that yes, I need to serve this devotee, please him, by his grace, I will receive Krishna's grace. Then Krishna becomes very pleased and accepts us. I remember we were in Kartik Yatra 2008. We had just begun, you know, our mega kitchen in our yatras. You know, you must have seen that episode on the National Geographic, mega kitchen. So many people were telling us, don't try these risks. It's not worth it. You know, it's not going to be easy. But he said, no, we will try. So after 4 or 5 days, there was a group of devotees. They came up and said, we also want to cook. You are getting all the mercy. Give us an opportunity. So I said, how many people you are used to cooking for? He said, we can cook for 100, 200 people. So I said, but here there are 3,000, 4,000 people. How you will manage? Then you have to empower, Baba. Take risk. Unless you give chance, how will others learn? So I said, okay, make one breakfast. So that day breakfast was poha, chipped rice. So they tried, it came out hard. So chipped rice, if you don't soak properly, it will become hard. So it came out hard. So I realized today will be a hard day for me. Because I have to hear 3,000, 4,000 feedbacks. So I was trying to, you know, go to my room hiding so that no one catches me. Right there when I did not expect, one devotee who is famous for giving feedback was right there. Some devotees are feedback priya. They are looking for opportunities. So he looked at me and said, hey, what kind of chipped rice you guys made this morning? My teeth fell off. I said, what chipped rice? Today morning breakfast was so hard, that chipped rice. I said, that was not chipped rice, I said. That was cornflakes. You're supposed to mix with herbal tea and drink. You know, oh really? He said, you never told me. I said, you never asked me. He got sufficiently confused and I went. So, all devotees have experience that sometimes, you know, more difficult than the service is the response to that service. And many devotees, many talented devotees are afraid of taking some significant service because they feel, you know, it will be so difficult to deal with the feedback and the various comments which are made. How will I deal with this? It's so difficult. So if all of us realize this, the essence of this verse, Vaishnavera gunagrahi na dekhai dosh, that if you are able to see the essence and understand that yes, let me try to see the positive. Let me try to appreciate and encourage. So then that becomes very attractive and pleasing to Krishna. And when that happens, Chaitanya Nityananda Tara Parama Vishwas, Chaitanya Nityananda Tara Parama Ullas, that he actually developed taste. When one overcomes fault finding and one sees the essence in devotee's character, the reward which Krishna gives is he gives us taste in hearing and chanting. And then Haridas Pandit was in this way a very pure, advanced, elevated Vaishnava. Kathaye sabha ujjwalakare yena purna chandra nija guna amrita badhaye Vaishnava ananda. He was increasing the devotee's ecstasy with his Harikatha, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's leelas and his divine qualities. Teho ati kripa kare agya koila more Gaurangara Sheshrila Varnibharatore. Out of great compassion and mercy, this Haridas Pandit ordered me personally. Please describe Mahaprabhu's remaining pastimes. And therefore, because of that instruction, I have decided to write the Chaitanya Caritamrita. Murkha, murkha neecha kshudra mai vishay lalas vaishnavagya bole kore eteka sahas. I am murkha neecha kshudra. I am insignificant, fallen. But on the order of the Vaishnavas, eteka sahas, I am having the guts to write this. So Shyamasundara Prabhu was mentioning that after joining Prabhupada for a few years, couple of years, then he got an order that he will be arrested and sent to jail. So he was very afraid what will Prabhupada's reaction be. So he came to Prabhupada and said, Srila Prabhupada, I have to go to jail. Prabhupada said, oh, Krishna was born in a jail. So he felt very encouraged, because generally, jail is not like a very favorable, positive place. I was giving a program in a jail. I gave a lecture. One prisoner raised his hand and said, I have a question to ask. So I said, ask. He said, but I want to come on the stage and ask the question. So I asked the commissioner of police, who is this person? He said, he has committed 12 murders. So I said, am I going to be 13th? Why does he want to come? He said, let him come, no problem. So then this guy came on the stage, asked this question, and all the prisoners clapped their hands. Even there is Pandit amongst us. He can ask about philosophy. So then after the program, I asked him, how you entered into the jail? So he said, I could not control my anger. And I have anger issues. And so the good thing about jail is, from speaker's point of view, audience is guaranteed. You don't need to advertise. So when Prabhupada heard that he is going to jail, Prabhupada asked, why are you going to jail? So Shyamasundara Prabhu said, Prabhupada, I was dealing with drugs. Prabhupada said, me too. I was also dealing with drugs. I was running Prayag Pharmacy. So then Shyamasundara Prabhu said, what should I do? Prabhupada said, don't worry, just continue chanting. You will be released. That's what he said. You will be released. So that the jail term was for 5 years. This was 1969. Within 6 months, mysteriously, the jail warden came and said, we have your release orders. Even till date, Shyamasundara Prabhu doesn't know how it happened. So that means if he was in jail, he would not be able to preach to the Beatles, not come to London, then Londoneshwar, everything is connected. So Prabhupada just said, you will be released, and he was released. And then he came to India. And then he was trying to set up this cross Maidan. So he was driving from, in Mumbai, in Kalbadevi market, very crowded place. And as he was driving, his car hit against a man, and the guy fell on the ground in front. So he became very afraid. The crowd surrounded him. And Shyamasundara Prabhu thought, they are going to beat me up. Then the crowd looked inside and saw Shyamasundara Prabhu, then started beating that guy who was hit by the car. So Shyamasundara Prabhu got even more bewildered. I made the mistake. They are beating him? Why? So he thought, maybe in India they begin from there. Then they'll come to me. And then suddenly the crowd moved apart and said, go ahead. So it was too much. He said, why did you beat him up? It was my mistake. So one man said, you are a devotee. How dare he disturb Krishna's devotee? So he realized, oh, the culture is so strong that even if you're dressed as a devotee, it is, people respect that so much. And then he has, successfully launched the Cross Maidan event. And in that, His Holiness Lokanath Swami, His Holiness Radhanath Swami got connected through that Pandal program. So, Shyamasundara Prabhu was sharing that we had no idea what to preach, how to preach. But Vaishnavagya bole kore eteka sahas. Murkha nicha kshudra mui vishelalas. Whatever disqualification one may have, if one simply tries to follow the instruction of the Vaishnavas, accepting that as Guru's instruction, then all the obstacles are removed. Sri Rupa Raghunath Charaner Eibal Yara Smrte Siddha Hoye Vanchita Sakal. And therefore, by remembering the lotus feet of Rupa and Raghunath, all the obstacles are removed, desires can be fulfilled. Echai Gosai Jara Charana Vandan Jaha Hoite Vighnanash Abhishta Puran. Obstacles can be removed, desires can be fulfilled, not by our karma, not by our power, not by our expertise, but by the grace, the mercy, the blessings of the Vaishnavas. And therefore, Kaviraj Goswami is demonstrating a wonderful example of being submissive to the instructions and the desires of the Vaishnavas. And he's saying that this Chaitanya Charitamrita is not a display of my scholastic ability. It is not an effort to supersede and compete with the previous Acharya Vrindavan Das Thakur. It is not an effort to demonstrate my greatness. It is simply a humble offering in response to the instructions and the desires of the Vaishnavas in Sri Vrindavan, headed by Sri Haridas Pandit. And that's the essence of what this verse is talking about. How one must be submissive to the instructions of Guru and the Gurus. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Any questions? Any comments? Jai Nitaya Prabhu.
Thank you for a very nice class. Thank you for helping me to realize I'm feedback Priya. Recognizing only faults. I did have one question. You mentioned these two reasons why Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami wrote Chaitanya Charitamrita. I was trying to remember there was also something Lord Nityananda had to do with him writing. How did that fit into these two?
Yeah, Lord Nityananda Prabhu is the one who gave him instruction to go to Sri Vrindavan. So on the instruction of Lord Nityananda, he actually comes to Sri Vrindavan Dham. And then later, he also glorifies the deity Madan Mohan. And he says that under the instruction of Sri Madan Gopal, Vaishnavera Agyapaya Chintita Antare Madana Gopala Gela Agyamagivare. And so he says that Egrantha Lekhaya More Madana Mohan Amara Likhana Yena Shukera Patan. That on the instruction of Madan Mohan, because when he goes and takes darshan of Madan Mohan, then the garland falls. And when the garland falls, he takes it as the instruction of or the blessings of Madan Mohan. Sei likhi Madana Gopalaya likhaya kashtira putaliyana kuhake na chai. I am just being made to dance like a puppet. And therefore he says, Kuladi devata more Madana Mohan Yara sevaka Raghunatha Rupa Sanatan. That my worshipable deity is Madana Mohan. So this Grantha was written in Govindev, but he accepts Madan Mohan as his worshipable deity. And so, Kuladi Devata More Madana Mohan. So therefore, the original instruction for Vrindavan Das Thakur to come towards Vrindavan is given by Lord Nityananda Prabhu. And therefore, Lord Nityananda Prabhu becomes the preeminent Shiksha Guru for Kaviraj Goswami, like that. Yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. I just wanted to ask one small question. So we see that Chaitanya Leela is kind of like a parallel to Krishna Leela, the pastimes, and it's sometimes seen like that, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna. And I just wondered if there's any comparison between Chaitanya Bhagavat and another book describing Krishna's pastimes.
No, basically Mahaprabhu's associates, all those associates, they have been given, the names of those associates in Krishna Lila is described in Gaur Ganodeshika Deepika. So there is a book called Gaur Ganodesh Deepika that is describing all the parallels between Krishna Lila and Mahaprabhu's Lila. So Mahaprabhu's Lila are described in Chaitanya Bhagavat by Vrindavan Das Thakur, Chaitanya Mangal by Lochan Das Thakur, in Bhakti Ratnakar by Narhari Sarkar, Chaitanya Caritamrita by Kaviraj Goswami. So there are many authorized literatures describing Mahaprabhu and his pastimes. Amongst all of them, Chaitanya Caritamrita is considered to be the most prominent in terms of giving the conclusion of the Gaudiya Siddhanta. Chaitanya Bhagavat is more Mahaprabhu Leela. But Siddhanta, if anyone reads Adi Leela of Chaitanya Caritamrita thoroughly, he can never leave Gaudiya Sampradaya because of lack of understanding of Siddhanta. Right? If you read Adi Leela, study Adi Leela, Chaitanya Caritamrita thoroughly, then you will get a comprehensive understanding of Gaudiya Siddhanta. So therefore, as far as characters are concerned, they are all described, different Leelas are described in different, but their identity is same only. Okay. Jaya Srila Prabhupada ki. Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki Jai Gaur Premanande.
His Grace Gauranga Prabhu ki. Hare Krishna. So thank you very much, Gauranga Prabhu. Nice to have you with us again. Very enlivening and inspiring. So please let us express our gratitude and appreciation by chanting very loudly three Hari Bols. Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Grace Gauranga Prabhu ki. So, for the pleasure of their lordships, now we have some Sankirtan scores. And today is the first day of our Radhastami sprint to distribute Srila Prabhupada's books, also as mentioned in the class, for the pleasure of Srimati Radharani and her on her appearance day, which is this coming Monday. And now we'll read out the Sankirtan scores. So yesterday in Radha's boutique, we distributed 12 books for 288 Lakshmi points. And in Govinda's restaurant, we distributed prasadam to at least 259 customers for a total of 2,420 Lakshmi points. And in Closet Krishna yesterday, they distributed one medium book for 106 Lakshmi points. And yesterday we have one book score from Vishodani Devi Dasi Mataji. Who's that? Anyone else? Oh, yes, okay. All right, Vishodani Mataji, wonderful. Okay, she collected 15 Lakshmi points, distributed 5 big books for 5 book points. Vishodani Mataji ki. Okay, so we now offer our prayer to their lordships. We just need some volunteers to help serve the breakfast prasadam this morning. Any volunteers to help serve prasadam on the men's side and on the ladies' side? Okay, and to help clean up after breakfast, the temple room. Any volunteers for this service? Okay, looks like none. Okay. All right, hopefully that will manifest. So we'll offer our prayer to their lordships. Dushi Shri Radha Landanishwara. Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Shishi Gauranitai, and Giri Govardhan. We offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. With a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire, we wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee, Srila Prabhupada, for London. Please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. We, the surrendered servants of your servants, humbly beg. New temple for their lordships, ki jai, Srila Prabhupada, ki jai. His grace Gauranga Prabhu, ki. Prasadam chain, ki.
Lokanam Vipadanam Vibhumani Jai Mata Di, 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 Jai Mata Di,